Officer is being honored. The funeral for Officer Roy Sims is underway right now. News 5's Curtis Fuller joins us live in Fort Wright with more. Curtis.
Well, Lisa, that funeral mass is taking place here at St. Agnes right on Dixie Highway over here. Always an impressive showing of support from the police community when they lose one of their own. We've seen police represented from throughout the area here to pay their respects to fellow officer Roy Sims. In fact, I'm told the family has received emails and letters from all across this country expressing sympathy for the tragic death of Officer Sims. He was a retired Covington police officer, more than 20 years there. And the past couple of years, he's been with the Northern Kentucky University Police Department. As you can imagine, it's been really tough on the folks he worked with here in the communities of Northern Kentucky.
I've noticed over the past few days that just talking about Roy and telling some funny stories or talking about what a great police officer he is and a great father he is, that's helping us get through it. And, you know, I think his legacy is going to live on for a long time.
Back live now, following the mass here at St. Agnes, a procession will make its way to Highland Cemetery, where 51-year-old Roy Sims, husband, father of five, a guy described as a good cop and just a decent man. We've heard that from everyone we've talked to since this tragedy occurred last week. He will be laid to rest at Highland Cemetery. Reporting live, I'm Curtis Fuller, News 5.
Thanks, Curtis. Officer Sims, as Curtis mentioned, leaves behind five kids and four grandchildren. If you can help out his family, a memorial fund has been set up in his name at every Bank of Kentucky branch.